time when pregnant teens were sent away to have babies in secret. But at the age of 15, Kate Howarth refused to give up her child for adoption. Years of hardship followed, but she's now an award-winning author. To tell us more about her fascinating story, please make Kate welcome. Welcome.
Thank you. Thank you.
I guess the best place to start is at the beginning for you. Take us back to when you were a teenager and your son was born. What were the circumstances surrounding that?
The circumstances surrounding it were fairly grim because the outlook was, or the expectation was, that I would surrender my son for adoption because that was the norm. And, of course, when you refuse to buckle, as I had done, the conditions go to what could only be described as being tantamount to torture.
Now, Kate, you had your son Adam with you for a couple of years.
Yes.
And then you were in a situation where you were forced to give him up.
Mm.
How did that happen?
But we're talking about 1967. And as anyone knows who lived through that time, the circumstances for a young woman or even a woman, an older woman who was raped, were pretty serious. You had to virtually have the life kicked out of you before anyone, you know, really took you seriously.
And that's what happened to you?
Yes.
No one took you seriously?
I didn't tell anyone because I knew they wouldn't take me seriously. And I was riddled with shame mm-hmm. and guilt that I'd put myself in a situation where it happened. So the burden went on to us young girls. We did feel responsible. I carried that burden of guilt for a very long time.
Which is, it's just shocking to think that you had to carry that yourself. And so did you then find yourself in a situation where it was hard for you to manage yourself, let alone look after a little boy?
Oh, no, that certainly wasn't the circumstance. The perpetrator of the rape, he had a Svengali-type attraction to me. He had raped me before, when I was 14. So he came back for a second dip. And I was very vulnerable to that. And he wanted me to run away, to leave my husband and run away with him. Well, that was just out of the question. Mm. There was no way I was going to do that. Mm. And then he threatened that if you don't come away with me, I'll tell John that I do. You.
And John was
my
your
husband. And I knew what the consequences of that would be. Mm.
If people at home are sitting and listening to your incredible story, thinking, wow, if that woman can dig deep and find that determination to move on, I mean, what sort of lessons can you impart?
When you're told or programmed from a very young child that you will never amount to be anything more than a prostitute, and I was told that before I knew what the word meant, and when you find out what that word means, and that's the level of expectation someone had for me, someone close to me, that gave me a grit, that gave me a determination to say, no, I won't. And so I'd say sheer determination, will to succeed. But understand, when I lost my son the way I did, without any hope of access to him because of the way the law stood at the time, I knew I had to better myself. I'd left school when I was 14. I had no education. I wanted the years, intervening years, to have amounted to something, that I did something with those years to go back and have my son look at me with some pride. And so it was just determination to do that that caused it.
And how is your son now?
He's the most beautiful boy in the whole wide world. And he's just amazing. He's a wonderful man.
Oh, he must be very proud
of
his mum.
He is. Well, in the end of the book, and I'll just give a little bit away, imagine if we've been through all of this and the reunion, although the reunion came when he was 16, there were many, many years that we still had to work through issues because Adam had been told a story which wasn't true about how I came to be separated from him. And at the end of, toward the end of the book, where I'm nearly finished this book, I get a message from my son on my text, on my phone, and it said, Mum, I'm so proud of you. Your courage, I don't know where to start. And he said, you're such a wonderful role model to Kate, that's my granddaughter, and you've shown me the true meaning of unconditional love.
I think that book is a gift to him as well as to yourself, Kate. It's called Settling Day, the book, and it is out now. Grab a copy. It's a phenomenal read. Kate Howarth, thank you very much.
Thank you so much.